Hi guys, good evening and welcome to another exciting episode of Atua Talks on your number one online radio service, Primus Radio. Yes, how are you? How did your day go? I hope you had a wonderful week and I hope you had a great day. And I hope, yeah, like I always ask you, I hope you're planning towards the weekend. I hope you're planning to have fun. Tomorrow is Saturday and you know what Saturdays are all about. It's all about Owambe, baby, go have fun and have all of the fun that you need to have. Oh wait, are you going to club tonight? Oh, if you need to go, please go have fun and shake your body. You need it. We all need to have fun once in a while. All play and all work and no play makes what? You know the rest. Yes, I welcome you to another exciting episode of Atua Talks with Erife Oluwa Omoneye. Like you know, I am the Erife Oluwa, the evidence of God's love. Omoneye. And I am your host for this lovely, amazing program. Yes, last week was all about heartbreak and, you know, things that has to do with heartbreak. Yeah, basically. So during the week, I sort of received a message from a particular young man, and he's seeking our opinion. Yes, our opinion. He's seeking our opinion, and this is quite a serious issue, as he's currently in a dilemma of what to do. Yes, I'll be right back. Stay tuned. Don't go anywhere.
Searching for the right, but it keeps avoiding me. Sorrow in my soul, cause it seems that wrong really loves my company. He's more than a man, and this is more than love, the reason that the sky is blue. The clouds are rolling in, because I'm gone again, and to him I just can't be true. And I know that he knows I'm unfaithful, and it kills him. I can see him dying. I don't wanna do this anymore. I don't wanna be the reason why. Every time I walk out the door, I see him die a little more inside. I don't wanna hurt him anymore. I don't wanna take away his life. I don't wanna be a murderer.
Yes, welcome back. You're still listening to Atua Talks on your number one online radio service, Primus Radio. And I am Erife Oluwa Omoneye. If you're just joining me for the very first time, yes, this is Atua Talks, where we talk about everything that has to do with your relationship, everything that has to do with your heart. And we try to fix whatever that needs to be fixed. Yes, that's all we do on this program. And I am Erife Oluwa Omoneye, the host of this lovely, amazing program. Yes. Okay, before I left the other time, I said a particular young man shared a story with me during the week and is currently in a state of dilemma of what to do. He does not know the step to take. I'll read the story to you guys right now. I'd like to know what you think. You can drop a comment at the comment section below or link up with me privately or send me a mail at tomilolaomoni99@gmail.com or WhatsApp me on +234 8066212517. So here is the story of a young man. I am a young man married to a beautiful woman, both in and out. Really. She is the best anyone could ever have. I am in fact grateful to God for the day I met her and the day she agreed to be my wife. She satisfies me with everything, a great wife to me and a great mother to our kids. I have two lovely daughters, by the way. Here's the problem. I started cheating on my wife during a pregnancy of our first child. I couldn't wait 9 whole months. Wow. I was sexually starved and needed someone. I needed someone, yes. She was always trying her best for me then, like giving me head and some other stuff. But I wanted more. I couldn't explore her body like I used to. After a while, at about the 6th month thereabout, I met a lady. She was all for the money while I was all for the sex. She gave me all I wanted and I did the same as well. After my wife gave birth, I stopped seeing the girl and became focused on my wife. 2018, my wife took in for our second daughter. The scenario of the first pregnancy started again. Then I met this lady. I have never seen such a lady like that before in my whole life. I wouldn't want to compare her to my wife, but she has some similarities in terms of attitude and her courage of herself. She has some similarities with my wife, and sometimes I see my wife in her. It wasn't about the money for her. She was more after the fun and peace, basically. After my wife gave birth, I couldn't leave her because I had become so used to her. And right now, I can boldly say I am madly in love with her. I've tried all I could to break off from her, but nothing worked. We both love each other and it's always like teenagers love. I can't afford to lose my family and I don't want to lose the lady as well. What can I do? Wow. The only thing I could say after reading the story during the week was just wow. Like, really? Wow. Okay, a lot of things are wrong in this story. A whole lot of things are wrong. Number one thing is this. During the first pregnancy, I want to believe nothing stops a wife from satisfying her husband despite being pregnant. You can always talk to your doctor about options. They will give you options. I understand the fact that he said he was unable to explore her body like he used to. I understand that perfectly. But that is not an excuse to cheat. It is never an excuse to cheat. Now, to the second thing. What stops a man from staying faithful to his wife for just 9 months? I understand it's not easy. You're human. Your body will request for it. And this woman, on the other hand, was always trying her best to satisfy you. And you still went ahead to cheat on her. That's quite wrong. It is very, very wrong. And you still allowed the same thing to happen to you the second time during a second pregnancy. That's unfair. That's really, really unfair. And you even went to the extent of falling in love with a girl. Like, who does that? You're married, for crying out loud. You are married. Have you forgotten the vows? Hey, I'm not here to judge you. Of course, I am not here to judge you. But if we are going to get anywhere with this case, we have to tell you the truth. The truth has to be told. You messed up. You fucked up. Big time. There is no justification for cheating. It does not matter what your wife does or how she behaves or whatever condition she is in. There is never a justification for cheating. If you cheat, it means, well, I don't know, maybe you don't value the vows you both shared. Cheating is something, it's, you know, one thing is this. What you never even thought about the fact that what if my wife gets to know? How would she feel? How would she feel even out trying her best to satisfy me? And oh my, no. You really messed up. But that, by the way, what can it do? Dear listeners, I am not a professional relationship coach. Yes, I am not. I'm not going to claim that. I am not a professional relationship coach. I know you guys have great ideas. I know you guys have you guys are smart. You guys have the best advice for him. Please do drop your comment at the comment section below, or you can hit me up on my Gmail at tomilolaomoni99@gmail.com, or hit me up personally on +234 806621 2517. I can be reached on that number at any time of the day, at any time. You can call or send a WhatsApp text message or anything. I can be reached on that number. And of course, your message will be delivered to this young man. Okay. Now you're saying, what can you do? In my own opinion, the first step towards you getting out of the situation is forgiving yourself. Forgive yourself first. I understand the fact that you might not want your wife to know. You might not want to confess to her. It's fine. It's okay. I understand that. But forgive yourself. And one thing that you need to do is cutting all contact with this lady. If it's possible for you to change your number for that period, please do. Because we are talking about your family here. We are talking about your wife. That's your future. That's a person you said you want to spend the rest of your life with. Not some girl you met because your wife was pregnant. So cut all contact with her. Discipline yourself and make sure you don't even think about her. If the thought of her comes up, look for a picture of your wife, look at it, and be grateful to God for the kind of wife God has given to you. Yes, I will still be sharing with you responses from listeners, whatever anyone says. I'm definitely going to get them across to you, Mr. Young Man. Yes. This is all I have for you tonight. I'll be expecting your advice, your comments, what you think he can do. I'll be expecting them at the comment section below, my personal line or my mail. I'll be expecting all of your comments and responses. Thank you for listening to tonight's episode of Atua Talks. I hope you learned something. Till I come your way again next week, Friday, same time, same radio station, Primus Radio, the best online radio service in southwest of Nigeria. Yes, thank you for listening. Till next week. Bye for now.